Right, guys, it's time to investigate this dome. Doomon, go check out the west building. I will go and check the north building. Ludwell, scout around the dome and take some samples.
Yes, sir.
Okay, guys, let's get moving.
This foliage doesn't seem right.
I concur, this moss seems to be floating like a fog. Shall I take some samples? Yes, take some samples, but be careful, we do not want to contaminate ourselves. I am entering the building now. Approaching West Building now.
Bill, quick, come, I found something!
On my way. Ludwell, what have you found?
I don't know, it's some kind of whirly thing with lights.
Bill, I have found something over here as well. That's the same kind of device Ledwell had found. What do you think they are, Doomon? I'm not too sure, sir. I'll have to analyze it further. What I can tell you is that it's not of Kerbal origin. Well then, guys, it appears we have to haul out the heavy gear.
Ooh, what has Bill, Doomon, and Ledwell found in that dome? Those mysterious devices, what are they for? Where are they from? We don't know. We'll just have to wait to find out. Anyway, welcome back to Kerbalinian Odyssey. This is episode 9. And you see here launching the Miss Minus probe. Because if you remember in the last episode, we lost our probe because someone didn't pay the electric bill. Well, we didn't have the solar panels pointed into the sun, so we lost power. And you see here, this launch isn't going quite to plan either. What I found here is that the top was too heavy. So when the fuel ran out in the bottom, the top got heavier, and you tried balancing something that's as thin as a pencil with it just heavier on the top, it is absolutely difficult. Anyway, what we do here, we abandon the probe, we get some science, what we can, and we thrust the ocean to make a bigger bang. Why not? We gotta make a bigger bang for our bucks. Anyway, what we do is we carry on, because from failure comes success. This is a Mixed Minus Probe Mark II. But I don't know if you guys noticed what was different about this rocket from the last one. Well, I'll tell you. A smaller fuel tank on top. Yes, in our orbital stage, I put a smaller fuel tank than originally planned, and that cut down the weight to the top of the rocket. So this is a design tip to all you guys. Put most of the weight of the rocket to the bottom, because you don't want the rock too much weight at the top. When you tilt over, you have a lot of trouble. And you see by here, now I'm trying to mess around with the camera tools. Limited success. I didn't want the probe to drop away. I wanted to follow the fairing and go away from the probe. But I make up with it with this flyby. So finally, we're going to get our probe into orbit after a failed launch and a successful launch. And the mission of this is to go to Minmus, collect that science we have from a contract. But now we have to do our inclination change. So let's also change our track. Something a bit more serious, I think. Because our science is serious. Well, once we've done our inclination change... Yeah, I think I burnt a bit too late for this one, so... Carrying on from that, we just run out of fuel before we do our transfer burn, and that means more space trash in the orbit of Kerby. In low orbit, to be more precise, is where I'm going to put my space station when I eventually get the stuff from. But leaving the Miss Minmus probe alone as it goes towards the moon, where it's actually going to Minmus, we have a calling from our Moho, more science probe. And I've been trying to get this to Moho for a long time. I only want a flyby of Moho. Anyway, there you go, more space trash around orbit around Kerby. This is going to be great. Luckily, the Kerbals are ignoring the space trash. Yeah, I still need to work on my camera tool thing. So what do I do here? I forgot what I've done by there. Oh yeah, this is the transfer burn. I messed it up because the probe kept on pulling to one side. It was messed up, but luckily I think it worked to my advantage. As you saw in the next minute, it was near quiet, 1600 meters per second, but finagling with the maneuver node, I get it down under 1215 meters per second, which is the amount of fuel we have left. and I also get a flyby of 600 kilometers around them. Moho. I'm back to our Minmus probe. We need that science to get our contracts up so we can unlock the parts and make further on our tech tree. Okay, I make a mistake by here. I don't know if you noticed. I thought that this maneuver node wasn't planned correctly, was it? Originally, I thought that I got my periapsis down to 6 kilometers. I don't know where you can see the mistake there on the numbers. Anyway, do some science high in Minmus. Come on, get your planets right. Anyway, I look at the Kerbal alarm clock and I think, well, there's something wrong here. Yeah, and I'd messed up my maneuver. So burning and using the Kerbal Redux mod, we get our orbit down to 6 kilometers, which was my original plan. I wanted a high orbit science and low orbit science. And eventually, with all this data, we can send a Kerbal, an unmanned mission, perhaps a landing? No, I think a Kerbal landing would be better. So yes, a time warp, and we get really close to Minmus. I think some of the mountains can even go up to 5 kilometers, eh? I'm not entirely sure. It looks really close anyway. It is a small moon. And I mess up here as well. We ran out of power while trying to transmit the Gunagu cast. I thought I lost that data completely. But when you come into the sun, I missed that. I don't know if you caught it. It did actually transmit the full data back when we got power again. But now back to the investigation at the dome.
Okay guys, what have we got? The device seems to be recording information using some kind of advanced magnetic tape. Plus it's cool watching those whirly things go round. It also appears to be emanating several forms of radiation, but only to the local vicinity. What are you saying? It's not the dome that's keeping these plants alive, it's these mysterious devices. Ludwell, keep monitoring the device. Doomon, let's go and check out the research building.
Well then, that's interesting information. But I can't say goodbye without a launch, and this is our manned, or Kerbaled if you want, mission to Minmus. Watch yourself, Tron. I put too much power in and separated for the rocket. That is mad. Anyway, I'm Orbiter. Thank you for watching. Like, subscribe, and all such things. But stick around for this ending clip.
What the? What is that? That looks like our solar system. Guys! That looks like chocolate ice cream! Guys, I found some snacks!